You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
It's time for you to discover you. There is more to you than meets the eye. Don't touch the remote now. I'll be right back to tell you about the power of self-discovery.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. And yes, there is more to you than meets the eye. And today's broadcast is going to be focused on the power of you discovering you. Oh, it's going to be so exciting because I have in the studio with me no stranger to Inspired Success, no stranger to Royal Proclamations events and programs, my colleague and friend, Marge Piccini. Marge, welcome to Inspired Success.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, what a pleasure. Great, great, great pleasure. Many of the viewers know you. They've probably seen you on one show or the other before, Inspired Success. Many know you from the community, and others have seen you and Kathy McAfee facilitating a networking session at one of my programs. You're no stranger, really, to this community. But I think that some might not really fully appreciate what it is that you do. So why don't you take a second to just tell viewers a bit more about what you do as a success coach?
Thank you. I too am a success coach.
Yes.
My focus is a little different than yours. My clientele are a little bit different than yours. Mm-hmm. Basically, who I help primarily are small business owners who really want to step into who they are and into full success in terms of their business. So there are people who are feeling constricted and constrained, or they've recently broken out of that type of a situation. So a lot of partnership divorcees I help. People that are broken out of the partnership and, they're going out on their own.
Yes.
And they want to be certain that they succeed in this new venue on their own.
Mm-hmm.
And I also help people who've recently broken out of corporate.
Yes.
And have started their business. And a situation that they tend to find themselves in is that they've realized that dream of becoming self-employed, but they get stuck and need to adopt a new mindset. So I help them to actually transform from being a business owner to being a successful business leader. That's the transformation.
Absolutely.
That I affect for
that's
them.
The transformation. And I fell because I'm no longer there. I fell in the first category where you talk about the partnership divorcee.
Yes.
And those are people kind of going through some form of transition in their business. Maybe they've broken away from a partner or a form of way of doing their business and are, venturing in another direction in a new way. I want to make sure they're successful at it.
Exactly.
Absolutely. And you may find this hard to believe that Princess Bola actually worked with Marge Pacini and actually signed up for one of your newer programs, believe it or not. Okay. And now you know I only work with the brightest and the best. You know that, right? You know this woman is a woman of excellence.
Thank you.
So that you know that, you know, Marge is good at excellent, not even good at her craft. But, you know, I the program that I took part of, before that, actually worked with, we worked together. You worked with me. Half-day sessions, mm-hmm. that was last year when I really began my transitional journey.
Yes.
And so you have been really instrumental, I must say. I must give you credit here publicly and publicly acknowledge and thank you, because you were a major catalyst in my journey as I was transitioning to discovering myself, my unique value, my calling, my place, and how I can best offer my strength, me, and best serve, you know, my constituent, those I'm called to, my tribe. Mm-hmm. And you know, you're a major, major catalyst and a major cheerleader. And I want to really acknowledge that and publicly thank you for that. All ears really need to be, you know, very close to the microphone and to this show, because you're going to get some real good tips and strategies. And we're going to share with viewers at the end how you can connect with Marge and some of the amazing programs that you have in the offering. But anyway, so this Discover Your Unique Value is a newer program of yours.
Yes.
Probably the newest program.
Yes.
And you've been a success coach for 6 years now, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And you suddenly came up with this new program about discovery, you know, yourself, you know, your value, your uniqueness. And now for you, in the way that you have you've set up your practice, it's kind of a first step program.
It is.
You know, so tell viewers about the power of self-discovery. Why did you come up with this as a first step to success? What is so powerful about discovering yourself?
What happened was, we, all of us, are constantly in the mode of personal development and personal discovery. It's something that is continual. It's perpetual.
Yes.
And so in my work with my clients from the very beginning, you know, there was a part of Discover Your Unique Value that I did.
Yes.
And then I kept learning and discovering new things with new clients. And really last fall was when I started to put some really interesting things together.
Yes.
And created this much bigger process.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a much more powerful and much more significant program. And so I broke it out of my other programs and made it its own, because it's that big of a transformation that people go through, and it's so foundational. I believe that the key to success is authenticity.
Okay.
It's all about knowing who you are and understanding your unique value. That's number one.
Yes.
Being connected to your passions and your purpose. Marry that to your passions and your purpose, and then carry out your dreams and your visions for your business and your life. So it's the very first part of...
Yes, it is the first step. And why is it a first step? Because for me, this is what I discovered. And that it is so foundational, so first step, like you said, because the place of our passion is the place of our strength.
Yes. And where do we gain our strength?
Exactly.
We gain our strength through our biggest challenges. So the biggest challenges that we have in our lives, I call them our dramas and traumas, are where we need to go.
Oh, okay. Now I know you're going a step ahead.
All right.
I want us to still come back there. We're going to go there. We're going to go there. But we still want to make viewers, I would like to make viewers understand why self-discovery is so foundational. Why it is the very first step to success. Because like, you know, I was saying, you know, that is the place of your strength. That is the place of your forte. You're in your element. You know, when you discover your uniqueness, your authentic self, your unique value, your unique giftings, you're in your element. The only way to succeed is to operate from a place of sense. When we're out of that, we're not in our elements. Mm-hmm. And so we'll be operating from a place of dysfunction, of, you know, out of position, out of sync, and you cannot succeed. So you've heard it. That is why it is absolutely important for you to discover yourself, for you to discover your unique value.
Yeah, you can't go on to be the you that you are destined to be without doing that work.
Absolutely. Yeah. How do you become something you don't know you are?
That's right.
And how, you know, you can't become something you don't know you are. You can't step into something you don't know. So the first step is to actually discover who you are, what your calling is, what your gift is, what your passion, and all of that.
Yep.
Now comes to what you talked about, the process of discovery. You know, because like you, I'm sure that you kept meeting client after client who was confused, you know, who was unsure, especially those who are multi-talented. Mm-hmm. They're multi-talented. Mm-hmm. I come across that. I was there too. Mm-hmm. I wasn't sure which was my primary gift, which was my dominant gift, you know.
Exactly.
I could do quite a number of things well. I'm a good event planner.
We can, because we're all so multi-talented. But there's this one thing.
Absolutely.
This one thing that you do, you do so spectacularly that no one else has the ability to do. And it's a matter of finding that so you can cut out
exactly
the rest and operate fully in that zone of brilliance, I
call
it.
Preach it, girl. You heard that. I got a preacher in the house. If you're tuning into Inspire Success, you're wondering what's going on. We're talking about the power of self-discovery. And I'm talking to my colleague and friend, Madge Puccini, madgepuccini.com. Mm-hmm. So easy to find her. And we're talking about the power of self-discovery. And you just said, you know, you discover yourself because this is the place of your brilliance.
Absolutely.
And this is the place of your confidence. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so you're not operating from fear, but you're...
And your place of self-love.
And your place of self-love. So your passion, your enjoyment. So there's joy in it.
Absolutely.
There's joy in it. It's not treacherous.
And energy and excitement.
Exactly. And you're waking up every day excited, you know. It is that place. And we need to find it, especially for those who are multi-talented, like we were just saying, you know. And I was there. So I could do a million and one things. I was a great event planner, a great speaker, a great mentor, a great motivator, you know, a great educator. And I had to go through your program to finally, you know, one of those programs I went through, but to finally be able to say, you know what? What is the dominant? This is my dominant.
Yes.
And one of the process that you took us through was looking at our experiences, our life's trauma and dramas, like you put it, and seeing how our pain, I say it this way, is connected to our purpose.
Absolutely.
How God somehow allows us to go through some of these life's challenges and uses all of that to be able to equip us to be able to transform others.
That's right. That's right.
And so you were talking about your challenges. Yeah. And talk a bit more about that.
Well, I believe that everyone is a healer. Mm-hmm. Everyone is a healer in some form or fashion. We have the capacity to heal. And there's a special way that we heal. And people are in a particular state when they need us individually. And we take them through a process. And then they're in a transformed state or a healed state as a result of that interaction. And how we do that, do our process, if you will, is through our work, through the experience and the opportunities that have been presented to us in our lives in order to learn and grow and develop professionally.
Yes.
So it's everything coming together to create you. But how do we find out what that special thing is about you? What is your zone of brilliance?
Yes.
So I take people through a life review. We go through your most challenging experiences, and everyone has them. And some people have a few, and some people have a dozen.
Absolutely.
But it's really, you know, individual for everyone. And from every single one of those experiences, you learned something. So it's like going into the mine, looking at those dark experiences again, but just very briefly, and then plucking out the diamonds, bringing them outside of the mine, and then doing some analysis. What do all of these circumstances have in common, and how have I grown as a result? And when you do that, you find that each experience was like one step on the staircase to develop you into who you are. That this transformation led to that transformation to that transformation. And the process that you individually went through relates completely and entirely to what your unique gift is.
Absolutely. And for me, there was loss was very much a part of my experience growing up.
And that was the drama or trauma.
Exactly. Yeah. And it eventually was what led me to find my faith, to find Jesus. Mm-hmm. And to build this very intimate and close relationship with him. And so I bring value to people who feel lost.
Yes.
And who are seeking a relationship with God.
Yes.
And so that is my value, of one of the values I deliver. And so I got it. I mean, it was just like, ooh, ha-ha, so many ha-ha moments.
Yeah.
That is brilliant. That's a brilliant part of your process. But I want to bring viewers back.
But it was, can I interrupt for a minute?
Yes.
But it wasn't apparent to you.
Oh, it wasn't.
Before the program.
Oh, no, it wasn't. Yeah. It wasn't apparent.
Because most of those experiences that we have, we want to keep hidden. We don't want them.
So put them in our subconscious. You had to ask. There were so many questions that you had to make us dig deep.
Yes.
To dig deep in, absolutely. You know, and all of that. Absolutely. It wasn't immediately apparent. But, you know, I want us to bring viewers back, you know, not to so much talking about the process, but also letting them understand the connection. Because for me, discovering yourself not only impacts, you know, the brilliance that you offer to the world, because it's the place of your shine, excuse me, and you're just shining so brilliantly.
Absolutely.
And it's your forte, and your gifting is, you're just good at it, you know. But it also impacts our bottom line, because this is how you help entrepreneurs. And I've met many people, you know, who are struggling financially. The entrepreneurs who are still struggling financially. Some are not even entrepreneurs yet. But what I have discovered is that there is a connection between discovering that place, zone of brilliance, as you call it. And I talk about discovering your purpose or your destiny or your gifting or your calling, whatever you want to call it. That's how I call it. But we're still saying the same thing.
Yeah.
Is that it does impact your bottom line.
Absolutely.
Because now when you're offering, what you're offering is valuable. It's valuable. It is unique. It is valuable to you. And you're attracting the people who really need it. It goes to demand and supply and begins to kick in here now.
Exactly.
At the end of the day, when demand exceed supply, because it's unique to you. You are the only one, believe it or not. And that's how unique you are. Look at your fingertips and your fingerprints, I beg your pardon. No one has the same.
That's right.
No one has your DNA.
Yeah.
You know, that's how unique you are, and that's how unique your value is.
Exactly.
And because it's uniquely yours, it makes it a scarce commodity because only you can offer it.
That's right.
And there's going to be a demand for it from how many million people on the planet? 6 billion? Hey, come on. So obviously, simple economics here.
Right.
It's simple economics. Hey, demand, supply.
That's right.
That impacts bottom line.
Yeah,
and how else?
So knowing your unique value is the first step. And then through the process, through the program, you learn the language that you need to use in order to attract the people who need your unique transformation, or who need you to deliver your unique value.
Absolutely, and you define it. You define it, and you helped
Yeah.
Ask coach that. You help me coach.
Yeah.
I help me coach me to really define what mine is.
Yes.
And I have one, a destiny statement. I awaken people to rise to their true and authentic selves and destinies, embrace it, and transform them as a result into change agents. That's me paraphrasing, but that's it. I see so many people doing too many, you know, they're not purpose-driven, they're not mission-driven. They're jumping from shore to shore, trying this business and that business, you know. And that is because you are yet to discover who you are. Who you are, who you truly are, your authentic self, your innate intrinsic value and calling. And it's time for you to do that, girlfriend. Look, you don't have much time left, huh? Some of us are on half time right now. And so we don't have time to play. You don't have time to play. And you know, the way you can also help others is, even if you feel you've discovered yours, what about your daughters? What about your young children? Mm. The sooner we help them discover and set them on that path, the better. That's Absolutely. A legacy we can give them. And so that brings me to the program that you and I have coming up, you know, that is designed to do just that. It's a process. It's not something you can, it's like you're talking about mining. I'm talking about digging deep. It's it's an exploration.
Oh yeah.
And I say that the greatest discovery known to humanity is self-discovery. Because when a person discovers who they truly are, it sets in motion this cosmic revolution.
Oh, it's life-changing. That Absolutely.
Literally transform the world when they release that kind of dunamis power.
Yes.
And so you have created this awesome program that's affordable. I have a Destiny Summit coming up for people of faith, my tribe, who want the more, you know, faith-based dimension to it, even though I feel that your program can, anyone can relate. I took it, and I'm a woman of faith, and it blessed my socks off. You know, that's just all I can say, you know. And, you know, but for those who I know, you know, the faith community, that you want something that's more, you know, biblically spoken in the language, the verbiage, I've invited Barbara Stumprud. She has a program called Training for Reigning, and she's going to be facilitating it at the Destiny Summit on Friday, October 25th and Saturday, October 26th at this summit. And you can go to my website, royalproclamations.com, to really help you to discover that, you know, uniqueness, you know, that calling, that vocation, that thing God has called you to do, and help you live in it. And then come the new year, I begin a mentoring and training program to help you thrive in it. But you have this you have this amazing program as well that entrepreneurs, non-faith people, anybody. Faith people can participate in, that I think is really powerful and very comprehensive. Tell us a bit more about it and when the next class is going to begin, and how viewers can plug in.
Great, I'd be happy to.
Yes.
So the program, the participants in the program are really an eclectic mix of people. So some are business owners already, and some of them are strictly business owners.
Yes.
Others are people who are change agents, transformers, if you will. And that's really interesting. And they may or may not be working doing that right now. So this program really helps them to discover what is your unique message. You know, what really are you all about, and how can you spread that out to the world?
Absolutely, absolutely. And that is absolutely the first step. You've heard it. You heard it. Mm. It is the first step to your entrepreneurial dream.
Yeah.
Whatever dream. So you haven't even started. You are not even an entrepreneur yet, but you're still trying to figure out, why was I put on this planet? What is it that I have to offer the world? What is my purpose? You have it. Discover your unique value. The next one is starting in the new year.
In the new year.
You already have a class going on right now.
Yes,
you have a fall program, but there's the winter program. And then there's this program. You know, if you're more of that, you know, spiritual faith person, mm-hmm. actually open to men and women. October 24th through the 26th, the Call to Destiny Summit, Awake, Arise, and Conquer, is going to take place at the Scout Conference Hall and Meeting Center in Abbey Road in East Windsor. Speakers coming from across the globe, from the Caribbean island, and you know, from Georgia, from down south. Barbara Stumprood, like I said, will be facilitating our program. royalproclamations.com is the place to find out more. margepaccini.com. You can hit us on Facebook. You know, I'm always on Facebook. And you can join this conversation, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. I'm everywhere. And I really want to encourage you, really, that it's time for you to discover who you are. It's time to live that dream, to be that person. It's time to operate in your destiny, your call. And it's time to stop this jumping from shore to shore and living in this confused state, in a place of fear, you know. It's time to stop all of that.
It's time for you to transform yourself. So you can transform others and
Absolutely.
Transform the world.
Amen. Say that again. Look in that camera. Which one is her camera? Say that again.
It's time That's to transform good. Yourself mm-hmm. so you can transform others. So you can transform the world.
So there it is. Transform yourself. It starts with you, right?
Absolutely.
Be the change you want to see in the world. Transform yourself. You're a change agent. God put you on this planet to change the world. Transform yourself. Transform what next? Others.
Others.
And then transform the world.
Absolutely.
You got it. The power of self-discovery. We're on that road. On that road to break forth the waters of your destiny and help you discover you. October 24th to 26th, royalproclamations.com. Marge is always here. Barbara is only coming for October, but Marge is always here in the Connecticut area. She also serves virtually. You do it virtually,
I do.
Actually.
Yeah.
So margepaccini.com. It was great having this conversation with
Thank you,
Marge. Thank you so much. It was great having you tune in and listening and being part of the conversation. Take advantage. royalproclamations.com, margepaccini.com, October 24 to the 26th, the first annual Call to Destiny Summit. Awake, arise, and conquer. Conquer this world. You were born to reign. So it's Princess Bola reminding you, keep smiling, put a smile on your face, okay? Keep learning, keep believing, keep networking, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I look forward to seeing you next month for another brilliant, using your words, Marge, brilliant inspired success. Thank you and God bless.